Welcome back to my channel. This video I wanted to just do another quite a simple line and wash painting, and this is probably going to be one of the easiest paintings you'll ever do if you do struggle with watercolor. If I know someone's reached out to me before, and as I say, things, this is easy, and sometimes it might not be, and I appreciate that. For me, it may seem quite easy, quite natural to some people, but for a lot of people, it may be quite difficult. So I've really stripped back this painting. I want to really sort of almost like a child's painting, I suppose. So I think this is perfect for beginners, and if you are struggling with watercolors. So like I said, I wanted to do another ink and wash, line and wash, and I cannot find the nibs for my ink pen. So I started off with the, I think it's some sort of masking tool, masking sort of pen, a drawing pen of some sort. But it was quite scratchy on the paper, and I am using smooth hot press paper, just to lend itself better to the ink. And I actually sharpened the end of this brush, as you can see. So you can use different, it doesn't really matter what you use to put marks with the pen on. You can use twigs, I've seen, and just any sort of long instrument you can use. Doesn't have to be sharp or pointed. As you can see, I'm using the end of this brush, which works quite well. It's always nice if you're doing a watercolor landscape like this to have a path going through the scene, and then just to lead your eye even more, if you can add some pause to something along, it just helps your eye travel through the scene. So now I've got the main marks there, and I want to add just a little pen work just to get some finer, smaller lines, some smaller details. It's kind of hard sometimes with a bigger point. There are many different pens you can use for this sort of painting. I've even seen different artists using just normal biro pens, which is absolutely fine. It can be done. You don't have to spend a lot of money on your ink pens. I think the only thing you need to look out for, if it's permanent and waterproof, that really does help. But here I'm using, I think they're a micron, possibly a Derwent or a Staedtler, something like that. So I do have a few different brands, and they're quite nice. You get different different size tips. So obviously you can get, this is 0.5. Oh, it's a manga pen. I think. So this is 0.5, which is, I'd say, sort of a medium tip. And then I just wanted to add a figure into this painting. I don't usually do that, but I just thought if I had a figure, maybe a dog walker, just to add something different than I usually do and something else to focus on. Because, like I said, it really is a simple painting. And if you do struggle, if you are having a hard time with watercolour, it can be frustrating, I understand. Then why not give this one a go? It really, really doesn't get any easier than this. And I can actually say this is quite simple. So I'm really not trying too hard. I'm not adding very much detail. Everything's very minimalistic. Even the figure and the dog, you can just see. Just a representation of a figure. Just a dot for the head and then a bit of a triangular shape, rectangular, and then a few limbs coming off that. It's pretty much it. And now I'm using my Hake brush just to get a bit of water onto the paper. And then I'll be dropping in. I'll be showing you my palette as well. I'll be using my Schmincke Horridan paints, which I really do like these paints. They really are highly pigmented. Really nice to re-wet the pigments and get some nice saturated colours. So this, I believe, is ultramarine or French ultramarine. So I'm going to use this in the sky. And then you can see I'm not really sure which colours to add, but I want to sort of dull that down. I don't want it too blue. So I'm going to just tap in some of the earthy, sort of dark browns. I think this is maybe a Payne's grey or something. Some sort of blue tone that's a bit more in the grey. So just adding little interesting marks in the sky. I don't want anything too spectacular. Just going in with this blue. And then I will be dropping in some yellow ochre as well. I don't know about you, but for me, fiddling around with details and trying making paintings just too perfect is one of my biggest downfalls, and it took me a long, long time before I could simplify things and paint in a looser sort of style, a loose style, which is referred to in watercolors. It takes a mindset. You need to change the way you think, and I think once you start painting in a looser style, it's just a bit more enjoyable, a bit more forgiving, and you're not after perfection at all. And so you can do paintings, and for me, it's almost as if I'm painting without caring of the end result. There's certainly no pressure there, and it's quite an enjoyable experience once you switch your mind to painting this looser style. So it took me a long time to paint loosely. It's kind of hard. It's almost like, as a kid, colouring in a colouring book, you're governed by these lines. You're trying to get everything within the lines, and that's fine. That's what that's for. But if you're painting and you're putting down the lines, you don't really have to abide by those lines. They're not boundaries, and you can paint whatever way you feel, whatever, in whichever style you want. And so I do find these sort of paintings nice and rewarding. So I wanted to do this really probably the easiest painting you'll ever do. If you want to have a go at this painting, there's no detail whatsoever, nothing difficult about this one, I can honestly say that. Just about having fun, just putting paint down and seeing what happens. You can see the way I'm using my brush, really not really being free. So I do like to paint these ones. There is a place for tighter paintings and a bit more perfection in painting. That's absolutely fine. But I think if you want to loosen up your paintings, then definitely opt for a bigger brushes and perhaps set yourself a little time limit. So this painting took me maybe half an hour, just waiting for things to dry and having little breaks here and there just to see where the painting's going and seeing if I'm happy the way things are going. And don't forget, there is a stage where things may look ugly, the ugly stage. You just got to push through that and look at the painting and analyze what you think would work in the painting. What could you add that will add some interest? And just have fun with it. You can see I forgot to press record, but I wanted to add a little bit of red roofs to these cottages, these buildings. And so I just added that and a little shadow underneath the roof. So it really does give a simple look. This is a really simple painting, and I think anyone of any ability is able to achieve this sort of painting. So just adding a few birds in the sky as well, something else I like to do, and I do like to do that with my drawing pens, just a bit more easier to control the tip of a pen, rather than the end of a paintbrush. But that's pretty much it. I hope you like this one. Let me know what you think in the comments section. Please do give me a thumbs up, give me a like. And if you're not subscribed to this channel, then please do consider subscribing. You can find lots of videos in my channel, beginner-friendly tutorials, as well as more advanced paintings. But I do have a few playlists on there if you want to feel free to check those out. And then just removing the last bit of tape, you can see what the painting looks like. as it's cropped and with a nice clean border. So that's it for this week. I do appreciate your comments, your thoughts. And like I said, this is not perfect. It's not. It's just a layered, stripped back, simple as I can do, painting, landscape painting, and just to help those who may be struggling or finding things difficult in watercolour. Want to give this a go? Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.